Hello friends, today we are going to discuss the physical examination of the ceiling. Now, if we look at the physical examination of the ceiling is done at the points like visual appearance, second, viscosity, ceiling volume, pH, sperm motility, sperm count, and the sperm morphology. Are you ready? The semen is physically examined with respect to these seven parameters: visual appearance, viscosity, semen volume, pH, sperm motility, sperm count, and the sperm morphology. Now, we will first study the visual appearance. If you look at the semen is thick and viscous. Second point, semen is opaque, white grey in appearance, white grey in color. But if the prolonged abstinence is performed or abstinence is done, this semen becomes yellow in color. The semen is usually opaque white gray in color, but if prolonged abstinence, that is, if the sexual intercourse is not done for a prolonged period, then the semen color changes to yellow. Now, the second point that we have to do is the viscosity of the semen. As we have seen, the semen is viscous, but this particular viscous semen, it liquefies within 20 to 30 minutes of ejaculation. The semen undergoes liquefaction within 20 to 30 minutes of ejaculation, but it doesn't liquefy within that period, up to 60 minutes, then it indicates abnormal semen. Are you ready? Semen liquefies within 20 to 30 minutes, but it doesn't liquefy within 60 minutes, or it gets liquefied after 60 minutes, then it indicates the abnormally viscous semen. Now, this particular viscosity of the semen is measured by the method that is called as the pipette method. What is done in this particular pipette method is that the semen is filled into the pipette and it is allowed to flow back into the container. Semen is filled into the pipette and allowed to flow back into the container. If it flows in a dropwise fashion, then the semen is normal. Normal semen flows in a dropwise fashion, but if it flows in the form of a thread that is longer than 2 cm, then it indicates highly viscous semen. Are you ready? Now, this particular high viscosity of the semen is associated with the infection of prostate or the seminal vesicles. The highly viscous nature of the semen is associated with infection of the prostate or the seminal vesicles. Now, what is the effect of this viscosity on the fertility of a man? That if the viscosity of the semen increases, it is associated with, it impairs the sperm motility. Sperm motility is affected by the increase in the viscosity of the semen. And the second point, it is associated with poor invasion of cervical mucus. Are you getting? We revise. Semen is viscous, with that liquefies within 20 to 30 minutes. But if it doesn't liquefies, it takes about 60 minutes for liquefaction, then it indicates abnormal semen. Now, the viscosity is measured by the method, that is called as pipette method, in which semen is poured into the pipette and allowed to flow back into the container. Agar wo dropwise fashion se flow hota hai, then it indicates normal semen. But if it forms the threads that are longer than 2 cm, then it indicates highly viscous semen. Now, this increase in the viscosity is associated with infection of the prostate gland or the seminal vesicles. And what is the effect of this increase in viscosity? It impairs the sperm motility. And the second point, it is associated with poor invasion of the cervical mucus. Now, the next point is the seminal volume or the semen volume. If you look at this normal semen volume, it is usually in the range of 2 to 4 ml per ejaculate. Normal semen ka jo volume hota hai, it is usually in the range of 2 to 4 milliliter per ejaculate. If this volume, seminal volume, is less than 2 ml, then it indicates or it is associated with low sperm count. Sperm count is low in such semen which is ejaculated at a rate which is less than 2 ml per ejaculate. Next point is the pH of the semen. The pH of the normal liquefied semen is in the range of 7.2 to 8. This particular pH is measured by placing a drop of liquefied semen, on a pH paper, for 30 seconds. The pH of the semen is measured by placing a drop of liquefied semen on a pH paper for 30 seconds. Now, if this pH is less, if the pH of the semen is less, along with pH is low, plus if there is azoospermic condition, azoospermic condition is nothing but absence of the sperms in the semen, then it is associated with two mechanisms. There is either obstruction of ejaculatory duct, or there is absence of vas deferens. And the low pH is usually associated with low semen volume. Are you getting? The pH of the semen, it varies between 7.2 to 8. The pH is measured by placing a drop of liquefied semen on a pH paper for 30 seconds. If the pH, low pH is combined with azoospermic condition, that is absence of the sperms, then it usually indicates the obstruction of the ejaculatory duct or the absence of vas deferens. The low pH involves the low semen volume. Next point is the sperm motility. If you look at the sperms, the normal sperms, they move at a rate of 1.124 mm per minute in a liquid medium. Normal sperms move at a rate of 1.24 mm per minute in a liquid medium. Next point is the sperm count. The normal sperm count, it varies between 100 to 120 million sperms per ml of semen, or 400 to 480 million per ejaculate. The normal sperm count is either 100 to 120 million per ml or 400 to 480 million per ejaculate. Now, there are three conditions that are associated with the sperm count. The first one is azoospermia. As we have discussed, azoospermia indicates absence of the sperms. Sperms are absent. Second one is oligospermia. Oligospermia is, name itself indicates, less than normal sperm count. And another condition is there, that is called as a necrospermia. Necrospermia indicates the sperms are there. Sperms are there, but all the sperms which are present in the semen, they are there. And the last point that we have to consider while doing the physical examination of the semen is the sperm morphology. Now, if you look at the normal sperm, this normal sperm, it has got oval tail, neck, middle piece, and the tail. But if you look at the sperms with respect to the head, following conditions are observed. Head may be round. There might be the presence of two heads. The head may be smaller, that is called as a microcephalous sperms or microcephalic sperms. The head may be larger, that is called as a macrocephalic sperms, etc. If you look at the tail, the morphology or abnormality that is associated with the tail is the tail may be shorter, it may be longer, there might be presence of two tails in the sperms. Are you getting? Now we will revise in a brief. The semen is physically examined with respect to visual appearance. The normal sperm, normal semen is white, opaque grey white in color. That may change to yellow following prolonged abstinence. The semen is viscous, but it liquefies within 20 to 30 minutes. But if it doesn't liquefy within that particular period, it indicates abnormality. Semen volume, the semen volume normally varies between 1 to 4 ml per ejaculate, 2 to 4 ml per ejaculate. The pH of the normal semen, it varies between 7.2 to 8. The sperm motility, sperm moves at a rate of 1 to 4 mm per minute. The sperm count, normal sperm count varies between 100 to 120 million per ml. And the sperm morphology, normal sperm is oval, it has got oval head, neck, middle piece and tail. There might be the variation in the head with respect to the shape. There might be presence of two heads, or the head may be smaller, that is called as a microcephalic sperms, or head may be larger, that is called as a macrocephalic sperms. The tail may be shorter than the normal, it may be longer than the normal, or there might be the presence of two tails. And all these conditions, all these abnormalities, they affect the fertility of males. Thank you.